couldn't keep up with I couldn't keep up with it because of time. Well, hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new, welcome. I'm Nina, the Simple Kenyan Girl. Please hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell to get everything coming right your way, from healthy tips to pregnancy tips and guides to parenting, motherhood. I'm here for all that. So if you have any questions, please leave them on the comment section or DM me or email me on this email. And yeah. Let's get started. So today we're going to talk about food poisoning. I wanted to catch this topic before the holidays started, and I just couldn't. I couldn't keep up with time. So luckily we are here, and it's good to get awareness, right? So let's get started. What is food poisoning? Food poisoning is actually an illness caused by food contaminated viruses, parasites, toxins, and it's usually self-treatable and self-diagnosable. You can tell by these symptoms that you have food poisoning, or if you eat in a junction that you don't usually eat, and then you start experiencing some of these symptoms, you will actually know if you're experiencing food poisoning or not. And I'll give you a quick solution about that. So yeah, so one of the symptoms is, and this is the commonest one, the most common symptom, is diarrhea-ing. So diarrhea-ing, nausea, vomiting, and stomach cramping. Yeah, it can be pretty uncomfortable, especially if you're experiencing all that. And one thing you might notice, you're losing lots of fluids in your body. So yeah, so pains, when we talk about pains generally, you can experience these pains from the abdomen or the rectum. And your body might feel like it's experiencing lots of chills, dehydration, dizziness. When you're dehydrated, this is one thing that I've realized with our body and our system generally. When you're dehydrated, you tend to experience a lot of dizziness and nausea, and a lot of fatigue, like you're extremely, extremely tired. So if you're experiencing any of this, just know if you're experiencing dehydration, you'll experience the other. And if you're experiencing nausea, you might experience the others. Yeah. Lightheadedness, it's too in combination with dehydration, loss of appetite, and sweating a lot. Another common symptoms are headache and feeling weak. We have gastrointestinal symptoms, which include bloating, stomach cramping, lots of gagging. You're just annoyed, not annoyed per se, like you just can't imagine yourself maybe eating that thing or this. We have diarrhea-ing and indigestions and lots of vomiting. So what is the quick solution about this? Of course, we want a quick solution about everything, especially when your body is feeling uncomfortable and you can't handle it. You just want to get over and done with it. Yeah, you need a quick solution, right? So what the quick solution is in this case is just avoid food for the first few hours as your stomach settles down. Let's, for example, you just started experiencing this uncomfort in your stomach and you're diarrhea-ing a lot. It's best to keep off any food as of that moment for a few hours until that stomach settles down. And another thing I'll advise you to keep on doing is drink lots of water or an electrolyte solution. An electrolyte solution is just a mixture of salt and water and sugar. This is just, it's really, really good. Especially this chemistry here explains why we studied chemistry. Yeah, so this solution is actually great because it enables the stomach to just settle in, like it's like a plaster. It just cements that whole area and everything settles down. Yeah, which will replace the minerals that you lose while you're vomiting and diarrhea. I know it's not a, you don't like feel like drinking all that fluids, but you just force yourself to drink that solution or water. And this, even when you are all done with the diarrhea and vomiting, your body still has fluids that enables to fight that bacteria or parasite that is in the system. Okay, yeah. So another thing is, eat when you feel like you're ready to eat. Don't eat just because it's the time to eat. No, eat when you feel ready to eat, but start with small amounts of food, and non-fatty foods. They're actually the best. For example, we have rice, we have crackers, we have toast, and plenty of rest is required. Because your body has gone through a lot of things, especially when they're experiencing vomiting and diarrhea, like it's struggling a lot, and drinking all those fluids, it needs just a small amount of rest or adequate amount of rest to enable the body to just process all that it has gone through. Okay, yeah. So some of the treatments that you might get from the hospital are, if it gets to a point that you're experiencing lots of fever and you need to rush to the hospital, or your baby is experiencing this, you might need, and they don't want to drink fluids, like, you know, yourself, you can force yourself, but if it's a child, you can't. So first, one of the solutions that they might be given is ORS. This is an oral rehydration solution, and it's actually given to hospital, that it's from WHO, all health organizations. So it actually enables you to get that boost of liquids in your body, and this actually gives the mother or the father or the parents or the guardians who are taking care of the kid peace of mind, knowing that at least there's fluid restoration in that body. Yeah, or even if it's you, that your system has enough fluids to run, especially after you have experienced a lot of diarrhea and vomiting. Yeah. Yeah, so ORS acts as a very good source of fluid replacer. And some of the medications that you can take if this diarrhea has been going on for more than 12 hours is anti-diarrhea. So I have an experience with someone who has gone through food poisoning, and I know it's not easy. But the diarrhea part, it occurs very often, especially when you feel like polluting the air, and it just comes out. It just comes out. And when it does this for more than 12 hours, I think it's the best time to go get a doctor to check you and maybe give you some fluid restore, something to replace the fluids, or a solution to it. Okay. Yeah. So I am so excited to be back. Yeah. On Health Tuesdays. I have been missing a lot, but I'm super pumped. I am back this year. I'm gonna be giving you 2 videos every week. I'm not sure if I'm gonna rest, because I am super excited for this new year. I'm so humbled that you're here with me. Yeah, and I will see you on the next video. Stay safe. I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.